Introduction to Clinical Trials. In this video, you will learn what are clinical trials, why clinical trials are important, how clinical trials are done, and who can join a clinical trial. What is a clinical trial? Clinical trials are research studies that involve people. People who choose to take part in clinical trials are called participants. Clinical trials help increase our knowledge of cancer and test new ways to prevent, diagnose, and treat cancer. Clinical trials in cancer may test new medicines or therapies, new radiation or surgical techniques, new ways to diagnose cancer, for example, with imaging or blood tests, and new ways to help patients manage cancer, for example, through diet or exercise. There are many different types of clinical trials. One of the most common types are treatment trials. This video will use a treatment trial as an example of a clinical trial. Why clinical trials are important. Every medicine, from painkillers you can buy at the pharmacy to cancer treatments, have been through a clinical trial. Without clinical trials, many of the medicines people take for granted would not exist. Clinical trials are the best way to find out if a new treatment is safe and works in people. All the standard cancer treatments used today were tested and developed in clinical trials. How are clinical trials done? Clinical trials are usually the last step in a long process. This process begins with many years of research in a lab. If the results from this research show promise, researchers may then start to develop a clinical trial. There are various groups that review and approve clinical trials before they start. For example, Health Canada and research ethics boards. All clinical trials follow a protocol. A protocol is a detailed plan for the study that the research team must follow. The protocol describes aspects like the aim of the study and how the study will be done. It also describes when the study will take place and how long it will last. All these details help ensure there is a plan for every step of the clinical trial. Participants are safe from undue harm, and the data from the study is accurate and provides benefit to the patients. Clinical trials are done in steps called phases. The early phases help ensure the treatment is safe. Later phases test if the new treatment works. It can take many years to complete all the phases. Phase 1 trials are usually small, with about 10 to 15 people. The aim of Phase 1 trials is to find out what is a safe dose of the treatment, what are the side effects, what is the best way to take the treatment, for example, by mouth or into a vein, and how the new treatment affects the human body. Only a few treatments tested in a Phase 1 trial will make it to a Phase 2 trial. Phase 2 trials usually involve less than 100 people. The aim of a Phase 2 trial is to find out if the new treatment works well enough to be tested in a larger group of people, which types of cancer the treatment works best for, and more about side effects and how to manage them. Phase 3 trials usually involve hundreds to thousands of people. Phase 3 trials compare new treatments to the best treatment used now. The best treatment used now is called the standard of care. The aim of a Phase 3 trial is to find out if the treatment is equal or better than the current standard of care, more about the side effects of the new treatment, and how the treatment affects people's quality of life. Phase 4 trials may involve thousands of people. When a treatment reaches Phase 4, Health Canada has already approved it, and doctors can order or prescribe it. Phase 4 trials find out more about long-term benefits of the treatment, long-term risks, for example, rare side effects, how well the treatment works when more people get it. Who can join a clinical trial? Clinical trials are voluntary. You choose if you want to take part in the study or not. Your healthcare will not be affected by what you choose. You can leave the study at any time. Each trial has its own list of criteria or rules that define who can join and who cannot join. These rules are called eligibility criteria. Eligibility criteria are different for each trial. The criteria depend on the goals of the trial and the question the trial is trying to answer. Eligibility criteria help keep patients safe. For example, being in a trial could make some people's health conditions worse. The criteria help identify these people before they start a trial. Eligibility criteria are also used to enroll people with similar characteristics. Examples of characteristics could be the type or stage of cancer, a person's general health, age, the molecular profile of the cancer, for example, the features of the cancer cells like genetic makeup, and any treatments a person has had in the past. Enrolling patients with similar characteristics helps ensure accurate study results. This is because the results will be due to what is being studied and not to differences between people. You may not be eligible for all clinical trials. Sometimes, clinical trials are not available for your cancer type. Some clinical trials are only an option if you've already had standard of care treatment. If you are eligible for a clinical trial, your care team will ask you if you want to take part. You will get written information to read at home. Ask your medical oncologist for more information about clinical trials and your options. By looking at all of your treatment options, including clinical trials, you are taking an active role in your care.